Hi students, welcome to my channel Doctors Physics, and in this video I am going to start the second chapter of the syllabus, that is motion in one dimension. There is nothing but motion in a straight line. Okay, before going to start the chapter, we should know few things, that is what is kinematics. Okay, what is kinematics? Kinematics is nothing but the study of a body which is in motion with respect to space and time. It is simply the study of the study of moving body with respect to space and time. The study of the moving body with respect to space and time. And I won't bother which made the body to move. Now, assume I hit the football. Now, the football may move in a projectile motion, or the football may move in a straight line on the ground. I will study how the velocity of the body is changing. I will study how the direction of the body is changing. But I won't bother which made the body to move. That is nothing but kinematics. Okay, we have to assume few things when we are studying about the kinematics. What is that? First one. Whenever the body is moving in a space, whenever the body is in motion, I have to assume that each part of the body has to move with the same motion. That means, you assume this body is moving with the speed 10 meters per second. I have to assume that each part of the body has to move with the same speed. That is first assumption. Second one. If the distance traveled by the body is very large when compared to the size of the body. That means, assume I started the bike. And I moved by on the bike for 1 kilometer. When I compare the size of the body, that is bike, with respect to 1 kilometer, the size of the bike is very small when compared to 1 kilometer. Then I have to assume the bike is a point object or point sized body. Whenever the distance traveled by the body is very large when compared to the size of the body, then I have to assume that body is a point sized body. Okay. Third one. I have to join each point in which direction the body is moving to know the direction of the body. That means, initially the body is here. Now the body, after 1 second the body moved here. And after 1 second the body moved here. After 1 second the body moved here. I have to join all these points to know the direction of the body. These are three assumptions we should make. That means the first, the motion of the body has to be same as the motion of the each part of the body. When the distance traveled by the body is very large when compared to the size of the body, then I have to assume that body is a point size object. Now, to find the direction of the moving body, I have to join each point the body is traveling. When I join each point, then only I will get the direction of the object or the body. These are the three things you have to remember. Next one, we should know what is rest and what is motion. Okay, what is rest? Same, what is rest? When the body is not moving, it is at rest. When the body is moving, it is in motion. Is it right? No. Now, same, whether I am in rest or motion, I am standing in a place, and same, whether I am in rest or motion. If you guys say it is I am in rest, I will say I am in motion. Why? The rest means I have to say with respect to some reference point. Like if there is camera, in front of me there is camera, well and good. With respect to the camera, I am not moving. Then I am in rest with respect to the camera. If you take that wall, with respect to that wall, I am not moving. Then I will say I am in rest with respect to that wall. But if I compare me with respect to the moon, I am moving with respect to the moon. Therefore, I will say I am in motion with respect to the moon. That means we should assume few reference points. With respect to that reference points only, we should say whether I am in motion or whether I am in rest. Now, assume. Okay, this is the road. Well and good. Now, some person is moving on the road. Assume it's the person's name is Sarath. Now there is some bench here. Okay. Now the person is moving away from the bench, then I will say this person is in motion with respect to the bench. After moving some distance, he stopped in the bus stand for 5 minutes. Then the distance between the person and the bench is not changing. Then I will say the Sarath is in rest with respect to the bench. Now suddenly the car came. Okay, well and good. Now the person entered into the car, the Sarath entered into the car and the car is moving. Now see me. Now I will say the Sarath, when the car is moving, then I will say the Sarath is in motion with respect to the bench, because the distance between the bench and the Sarath is changing. Therefore, I will say the Sarath is in motion with respect to the bench. Now, again I will say, where the Sarath is sitting, the Sarath is sitting in the car. Well and good, the car is moving. I am Sarath, I am sitting in the car and the car is moving. Well and good. Now, with respect to the car, I am not changing my distance. My position is not changing. Therefore, I will say the Sarath is in motion with respect to the bench, but and the Sarath is rest with respect to the car. Everything is clear. That means I have to assume few reference points, then only I can say whether I am in rest or in motion. Now when I am sitting in the train, now with respect to the train, I am in rest. But with respect to the surroundings, I am in motion. Everything is clear. What is rest and what is motion? Okay, well and good. But when it comes to the problems, we can't assume the bench as a reference point. I can't assume the pole as a reference point. I have to assume few things which we can solve the problems. Then there comes the coordinate system. The best reference we can take the coordinate system. The coordinate system containing three directions, that is x, y and z. And all the coordinate axes will meet at a point, that is origin. And when you are solving the problems, we have to assume the origin is a reference point. I have to assume the origin is a reference point. I have to find my distance. I have to find my velocity. I have to find my acceleration with respect to a reference point, that is origin. And we have to compare the motion of the body with time. That means I place a time. That means I place a clock in this coordinate system. Three axes joining at a point making an origin, and this total construction is nothing but a coordinate axis. And when this coordinate axis having some clock, that means with respect to time. Now time is like assume 12 a.m. Now the body is somewhere here. Now I have to compare this motion of the body with respect to this time. At 1 p.m. the body is somewhere here. That means as the time is passing by, the body is moving with respect to the origin. Therefore, I will say this body is in motion, and this coordinate system, when this coordinate system is having the clock, then I will say this whole reference, this one has a frame of reference. The frame of reference is nothing but simply the coordinate system, which is also having the clock. The clock means this imaginary clock. That means the motion of the body will have to change with respect to the time. How the body is changing its position with respect to the time, that system, the coordinate system is nothing but we are assuming it as a frame of reference. I think this is clear. Three axes meeting at a point called origin, and this origin is nothing but the reference point, and how the bodies are changing its position with respect to origin will give me the values, the velocities, displacement, distance. But to find them, I need time. Therefore, this coordinate system, I am placing a time, that means a clock. Now, this coordinate system along with the clock will form a frame of reference. That means with respect to this, I have to measure the values, how the body is changing, how the speed of the body is changing, how the velocity of the body is changing, everything. And now, in this frame of reference, there are two types. Inertial frame of reference and non-inertial. We will study about this deeply when we are studying Newton's laws of motion. But now we will see what is inertial frame of reference. Now see here. I am standing here. Now there is car moving side to me. The car is moving, well and good. Now I am the observer. Okay, now I am moving or I am in motion or I am in rest. I am in rest. Okay. Now with respect to me, the car is moving. I am the observer. Now the place where I am standing,
I will assume it as a inertial frame of reference. That means the observer should not move. The observer should be at rest with respect to the surroundings. Then that frame, that surroundings, I will assume it as a inertial frame of reference. That is nothing but if I take this corner system, you are some person, you are here. With respect to you, the object has to move. Then you are in inertial frame of reference. But now I am in car. The car is moving with some acceleration. Well and good. Now some side to you, there is one more car moving with some other acceleration. Now you are watching that car. Now say me, whether you are in rest or motion, I am in motion with respect to the surroundings. Now, even though I am in motion with respect to the surroundings, but I am the observer. I am seeing the car, it is moving with some more acceleration. Then I will say I am in non-inertial frame of reference. That means when the observer is in motion, that means when the observer is moving some acceleration, then that surroundings, that frame of reference is known as non-inertial frame of reference. That means inertial frame, or I will call the inertial frame or non-accelerating frame of reference, and I will call non-inertial means I will call it as a accelerating frame of reference. That means when the observer is in rest, inertial frame of reference. That frame of reference I will assume as a inertial frame. That means frame of reference is not moving. Now when the observer is in motion, that means in acceleration, then the frame of reference also is moving. Then I have to assume it as a non-inertial frame of reference. I think this is clear. What is frame of reference? Frame of reference is nothing but a coordinate system having a reference point, that is origin, and the motion of the body is changing with respect to origin along with the time. There is some clock which I place in this coordinate system. With respect to the time, the positions are changing. Then this coordinate system along with this clock, I will say it as a frame of reference. This whole set is nothing but a frame of reference. I have to study everything in this frame of reference. I have to study the motion of the body. I have to study the velocity of the body. Everything we will study when it comes to the problems, we have to study in this frame of reference. Okay. Now this is a reference point. Well and good. Now the body is moving. The distance between the origin and the body is continuously changing with respect to the time. Then I will say this body is in motion. Now the body is here. The distance between the origin and the body is not changing with respect to the time. The clock, the time is increasing, but the body distance is not changing. Either the distance can increase or the distance can decrease. But nothing is happening. Therefore, I will say this body is in rest. I think it's clear what is meaning of rest and what is meaning of motion. Rest and motion always has to be considered with respect to a reference point. And when you are solving the problems, this is our reference point. That is, this origin is our reference point. And we will study everything in this coordinate system. And this coordinate system along with clock, I will call it as a frame of reference. And this frame of reference, when it is in at rest, that means when the observer is at rest, then I will call this as a inertial frame of reference. When the observer is in motion, then I will call it as a non-inertial frame of reference. Observer means that nothing but this origin. We will always observer has to stand in this origin. When this person is moving, that means the whole system is moving. This person, this observer, always observe, we should assume as the origin. Now when the person is in rest, that means the frame of reference is at rest. Therefore it is inertial frame. But when the person is moving, that means the origin also moving. When the origin is moving, that means the whole coordinate system is moving. Then I will assume it as a non-inertial frame of reference. Okay, this is the basics we have to know when we are entering into the chapter. In next video, we will start the actual topic, that is distance, displacement, speed and velocity. And if you guys are having any doubts, it may be any chapter, it may be from 11th class, it may be 12th class, please mention in my mail, and within 24 hours the doubts will be clarified. Thank you.